What are we leading off with?
The Heebie.
Good, because I got okay, your job. Pick up. What about the break? Where I do the bottom, who's going to cover?
Honey, you're coming back.
I'll just keep up there for a couple of hours. Don't worry.
Yeah, then you come back home for this good inbred life.
Who's taking the B flat?
Whoever gets there first. Just hold on to
okay.
it.
Okay, here we go.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Berkshire Theater Festival is proud to present a musical tribute to the Boswell sisters, the HeebieJeebies.
Take it from the jump.
Hold on.
Share with you the songs and sounds of the Boswell sisters.
We're going to tell about their lives and careers, sometimes portraying them and other times just telling their stories.
Mostly we're going to sing. Like Caroline.
A one, two,
to the world, to leave you behind.
love and I know you will. Wa-lu-la-lu-la-bum-bum. Spend an evening in Caroline.
Yes, sir, say what you like. I know what it's like to be glad right now. Yes, sir, say what you may. I never could ever be blue, no how.
First ever, that's really out together. Father, to love Caroline. Wa-lu-la-lu-la-bum-bum. Spend an evening in Caroline.
Sisters, Connie, Martha, and Vic.
Now, some of you may not know about these ladies.
Well, there were three folks who loved to sing.
Together.
They were just about the hottest harmony team ever.
You see, they were jazz singers. Well, not exactly jazz singers, because they sang with that classical precision, but in popular songs. They weren't popular singers. I mean, they were popular. They sort of sounded like...
They sounded like the Boswell sisters.
Right. The Creole beauties with the flashing eyes, making jazz popular. It's been in a musical style that influenced the group.
Like Ella Fitzgerald.
Crosby's crooning. The Dorsey brothers' way of weaving around a singer's melody line.
And your sister's harmony.
The Gum sisters. Now, they split up, but the little one stayed in the business, changed her name to Judy Garland. We could go on and on. I think we just did. They sure started something.
Taking from all those around them. What was around them was New Orleans in the 1920s.
Lord, my sisters and I have been making music together since we were knee-high to a duck.
I got news for you, honey. We were reading music before we were reading writing. We grew up in what you might call a music man household. Everybody. Our mammy, Uncle Charlie and A-Man.
Mom and Pop.
Always. Playing and singing.
Our daddy, Mr. A.C. Boswell, had us trained in classical music by the renowned Professor Otto Fink. Before long, we could play just about every instrument. I guess he hoped we'd be playing classical music in Carnegie Hall.
That was all right with us, but you couldn't live in New Orleans in the 20s without thinking of the spirit of hot jazz and blues. Street corner,
church arm,
sitting outside the tumble hand,
taking off with Innerarity sisters on floor.
Wasn't old then.
Going through Storyville in the quarter and listening.
Just listen. Those backstreet harmonies and gut bugging blues. We picked it up and laid it down.
Yes, ma'am. Papa left town on business for a time, and when that engine steamed out, we started steaming up.
We started steaming up. We cleared the furniture out of the parlor.
Plenty of room for dancing.
Jamming with the Prince Louis Prima and Tony Peretti.
Sweet Evan.
Sweet Evan.
Of course, we continued giving our classical recitals on the piano, violin, and cello. Then, for an encore, we put down our instruments and start in singing. A few tunes they weren't expecting from three proper young ladies.
See, we take a little of what Papa taught us from Mr. Mozart.
And then sort of jazz it up.
Then we put down a tune we learned from our man.
I hate to see that evening song.
Dog of his were listening. They must have liked what they heard because this was their first song for his master's voice.
That was March of 1925.
I think of you only, for no one else will do. even in this early tune, the Boswells showed how they could take a lovely little melody line and make it cook, but turning it inside out and upside down.
And here they do it with gibberish or double talk. It's a kind of a pig Latin they learned from their daddy when he didn't want them to know what he was saying. And they turned it into music,
just like everything else. There were no trimmings, no microphones.
You see, there was this big horn across to the other side of the room. It wasn't a horn, really. It was more like a cone. It was shaped something like this. And there was this big metal drum with wax in it, and this man was standing there with a knob, or was it a leather? Anyway, they would stand over there, and the big metal wax thing would be here, and the wax would come down through this tiny little thin tube, and they just sang
like they were calling in Texas for supper.
Now, if they wanted the sound of a trumpet or a banjo plunk, they'd just create that sound themselves. It sort of caught on, and it was fun.
So they recorded this blues number that Martha wrote, inspired by their idol, Mamie Smith. The youngest one was, what, 13?
Not that?
13 at the time.
13? Teaching them to take what life offered and turn it into joy. When Connie was little, she had polio. Now, this was just a part of life, and they dealt with it.
Connie was a spirited character, and no sympathy was ever needed for her.
She could get around. She rode a tricycle. She learned how to ride a horse. She'd climb trees with her strong arms, and if she wanted to go to town, she'd just take hold of her two sisters and step out.
Close harmony, closer hearts. Always working, playing, and singing together as one.
Loving to be with each other and always having fun. They were nicknamed the Cats and Jammer Kids.
They were also the first women to ever perform on stage in trousers.
It was easier for Connie to get around that way.
So they all wore them. They even drove car ensemble. Connie on the wheel, Van on the pedals, Martha on the mat.
When they performed, it was always just like this. Around the piano, Connie on the bench singing lead.
There's no sweeter one.
the bass line.
Beneath the Dixie, beneath the Dixie sun, news is spreading all about a wedding. Oh, I hear the church bells ringing. That's why my heart keeps singing. Dinah, is there anyone for Dinah in the state of Carolina? If there is, and you know her, show her to me. How I love to sit gazing to the eyes of Dinah Lee. Every night, what do I speak with pride? Because my Dinah might change her mind about me.
Georgia, he's jealous of the ladies all the time. When it comes to love, and there is not a thing that he don't know. I'm talking about
invited him. Thinking we were established professionals, he offered us a split week's booking in Chicago's Englewood and Belmont Views.
Now, your average parents might not let three teenage girls leave home to enter show business.
With no chaperone?
But they knew that a chance to spread us down was too good to pass up.
So, Mama and Papa gave their blessing and a pair of brass knuckles.
Connie took those. If there was any trouble, we'd steer it her way, and she'd knock it in the next week.
Although we loved our home, the thought of playing Chicago was too thrilling for words.
I'm sure we'll find some.
Chicago. Jazzy, free-blowing as a Boswell second chorus, where the only rule was to break the rules. And we did just that, taking our music and swinging it in every direction from here to Tuesday.
We just couldn't wait to move up that river and get that town.
Let's go!
Yes, ma'am.
Hear that whistle, echoes of bell. That means we're on our way.
Shut to save ourselves from giving a free show.
Traveling in an old Ford, it was all then.
With a motorcycle act that shared the bill.
Racine, Wisconsin. The princesses of melody changed their first tire.
Miami, Oklahoma. A bit of a language barrier in this town. An audience of all Indians wrapped in blankets. They looked pretty serious when we came out.
But they understood our music and we left them smiling.
Detroit, thrill of a lifetime. First star spot, first star on the dressing room door.
Maryland, across the West, we finally got to San Francisco on New Year's Eve, 1929. We had a ball.
We sure weren't doing it for the money.
In one town, they paid us $3 for two shows. It's a dollar per sister.
I never did like Oakland.
Well, San Francisco put us right on the California Melodies album.
And down to Hollywood, KFMV.
Just act like Yes, we have your bananas.
Today.
I guess you could say we were in the right place at the right time, and that was a gift.
While panic was sweeping the country, our music was gathering steam, putting a little harmony in the confused hearts.
Just keep right on smiling.
Right track. Our audience has told us.
We were scabby ladies, working around the clock to keep America singing.
Life's just full of cherries. Don't make it serious. Life's too mysterious. You work, you say, you worry so much. Can't take, you know when you go. So keep on repeating honey in the things of days. The strong you stroke must fall. The sweet things in life to you are just low. So how can you lose what you never owe?
Stage show and a movie. They were lining up for blocks.
Think into that plush velvet seat.
And the Paramount, the Capitol, the Roxy.
Ladies and gentlemen, ladies and gentlemen, ladies and gentlemen.
to put that smile back on your face. When we put that smile, when we put that smile, when we put that smile back on your face. Sing a little tune.
That's what we want under the moon. Gotta put that sun back in the sky. Gotta teach those bluebirds how to fly. Thinking I love you some, love you some, some. Just the time goes by. America's top radio shows.
The Woodbury Soap Hour. The Chesterfield Hour.
The Fleischmann Yeast Hour.
And any Monday, Wednesday, Friday at 7:30 p.m., you could tune in to hear the theme song from the Baker Chocolate Hour. Nothing is sweeter than you.
town.
They did this one short where they all played farm girls
called Close Farmony.
They were all in this... haystack.
Even the piano. You could see where the keys...
We thought we'd have done that one for you.
And we had hay everywhere. And in the next number, we didn't need any hay, and we had hay everywhere.
What about that number they did in Transatlantic Merry-Go-Round? They did this number in a rowboat. It was called Rock and Roll.
Oh, I love that one. We couldn't get the boat through the door. And then we needed all that water. It was quite a mess.
What about crazy people?
I think we're ready for it. Chris?
People
Crazy people, crazy people, crazy people, crazy people like me go crazy over people like you. Goofy people, daddy people, dead people like me go crazy over things you do. I don't mind if I a lot, sweet angel child. It's just that I got you drive me wild. Crazy people, crazy people, crazy people, crazy people, crazy people like me go crazy over people like you.
From the film The Big Broadcast.
There was another big broadcast for the Boswells. It was the premiere of national television.
First time they went on television was the first time television went on.
They were in pretty good company. Kate Smith and George Gershwin.
Mayor Walker.
Had a ball with Gentleman Jim.
Always singing together.
But not as three little girls around the piano anymore.
Now they were grown up.
You can hear this in their new outlook on the old standards. And in Connie's solo turns.
We'd like to do a few of our favorites for you.
Oh,
But there was no arguing with the king's position. So they put the Boswell sisters into royal quarantine. But they snuck out the back door and Connie recovered in Cannes.
Where?
France.
Oh, then up to Ovations in Holland. A trio of
ambassadors. When they met Prince George, they really did try to behave, but Connie nearly ran him down. The vet tripped up on her curtsy. Martha looked up at him and said, Have you got a cigarette? Y'all heard this story before?
I think so.
Yeah.
Well, he just loved it. He sat down on the floor and sang along with him.
Where was that?
Oh, a trio of ambassadors for America's baby, the jazz sound, spreading their style and taking new turns in their music.
2, 3, 4.
Lighting, even subtitles. Through high times and hard times.
And they had those.
The love for singing and the spirit of joy carried them through. But they could get lonely and deeply miss the people that made it all possible.
The folks at 3937 Camp Street, New Orleans, Louisiana.
Carrying the South with them no matter where they went.
And always coming back to the sounds they grew up with. The Boswell sisters. Signature song, Shout, Sister, Shout.
Oh.
they made around the piano in New Orleans was accepted and loved across the United States and Europe.
Never missing an interest. They were there for the beginnings of jazz, radio, the talkies, the record industry, and television.
And always doing what they loved with the ones they loved. It was a privileged life, and they returned that privilege with the gift of joy and harmony to the world.
Opening the door for women in jazz. One day, Connie had an idea, and she took it to President Franklin Delano Roosevelt. Together, they started the March of Dimes.
March 15, 1936, headline in the Journal American, Bette Boswell secretly married for 15 months.
Well, Martha soon followed her younger sister's lead, and they both left the business to raise families.
Connie already had her own radio show, and she married their manager,
and continued with a solo career that spanned over 40 years as one of America's top vocalists.
Soon, the baby don't know.